It gives us enormous pleasure to introduce the next combo, who are... Her Majesty! Queen!
In the summer of 1985, music history was made at London's Wembley Stadium. Live Aid, a global music event organized to raise funds for famine relief, witnessed legendary performances from some of the world's most iconic artists. Yet, when we think of Live Aid, one band's electrifying performance always stands out. Her Majesty, Queen. At Live Aid, Queen's 20-minute was a revelation. They opened with Bohemian Rhapsody, a song that has always been a classic, but what made this performance truly special was how they commanded the entire crowd and how much connection Freddie Mercury had with the crowd. After that, Queen performed Radio Gaga, my favorite Queen song, and during the show, a stadium anthem that felt like an anthem for entire event. As the audience stomped and clapped in unison, the stadium shook with collective energy. The sense of unity was very noticeable, creating a collective energy that seemed to transcend the physical boundaries of the stadium. We made sure that everyone was enjoying the wonderful thing that is music. As Brian May said, Freddie Mercury, with his boundless charisma and magnetic stage presence, knew how to captivate an audience. He engaged with the crowd, breaking the barrier between performer and the audience in a way that was pure magic. Mercury's posture, gesture, and expressions oozed with confidence. He danced around the stage with a commanding presence, radiating assurance with every step and every note he delivered. His use of expressive hand gestures, facial gestures, underscored his emotional connection to the music and to the audience. His gestures seemed spontaneous and genuine, emphasizing his deep involvement in the performance. Mercury's physical interaction with the audience were a main aspect of his body language. He engaged the crowd through a simple yet powerful gesture, like raising his hand to cue the audience to sing along. He extended himself both physically and emotionally toward the audience, breaking down the barrier between the stage and the crowd. Despite his commanding stage presence, Mercury displayed moments of playful and vulnerability. He would flash a mischievous grin, making the audience feel like they were sharing an inside joke. The audience was visibly euphoric, responding to Mercury's body language with unimaginable joy. They cheered, they clapped, and they sang along. Many fans who attended Live Aid have spoken about the deep emotional connection they felt with Freddie Mercury. This emotional connection made the performance more than just a concert. It became a shared experience between Freddie Mercury, Queen, and the whole audience.
This next song is only dedicated to beautiful people here tonight. It means all of you. Thank you for coming along and making this a great occasion.
Freddie Mercury's body language and the audience's reaction to it primarily appeal to pathos. Pathos is the appeal of emotion and feeling. Mercury's charismatic and emotional charged performance stirred the audience's emotions, fostering a deep sense of connection, joy, and unity. The audience's cheer, tears, and lasting impact of this performance are a testament to the emotional power of Queen's Live Aid performance. Queen closed their set with We Are the Champion, a final tribute to the spirit of Live Aid. It was the anthem of triumph and solidarity, and the audience joined in, singing with all their heart. The entire stadium was cheering, and so was the world. Queen had done the impossible. They had stolen the show at an event that featured some of the greatest musicians of that time. Queen's Live Aid performance is known for capturing the crowd's entire attention, not just for 20 minutes, but for a lifetime. It is a reminder that in the world of music, some moments are not just fleeting, they are timeless.